It's empty in the valley of your heart. The sun, it rises slowly.
What's up, guys? Happy hump day. Oh, Wednesday in the middle of the week. Hope everybody's week's going well. Today's workout, you're going to start a 15-minute running clock. On that 15-minute running clock, we've got 6 different movements. You're going to start out with deadlifts. So we're going 5 rounds of 20 seconds of deadlifts with 10 seconds of rest. Then you'll move on to 5 rounds of 20 seconds pull-ups with 10 seconds rest. You'll then move on to 5 rounds of 20 seconds of cleans with 10 seconds rest. Then moving on to 5 rounds of 20 seconds of push-ups with 10 seconds rest. Then 5 rounds of swings with 10 seconds rest. Then 5 rounds of sit-ups with that 20 seconds of work and 10 seconds of rest. All right, so once again, there's 6 different movements here. It's Tabata style, not full Tabata. It's only 5 rounds of that work. So you're working for 20 seconds, resting for 10. You're doing 5 rounds of that with that movement on each of these. Score is gonna be completed reps in all these movements. All right, guys, we're talking about the warm-up. Our warm-up today is just going to be 1 round. It starts with a 200-meter jog. If you're inside, you're going to just run in place for 30 seconds. We're trying to get the heart rate up, so really start really jogging hard in place, okay? 15 air squats, our traditional air squats. Here's a chance to get really good at doing air squats. Take them nice and slow. It's just the warm-up. From there, we add in lateral lunges or our Cossack squats, right? So we're lunging out. Think of the weight still being in the heels, the knee still tracking up, the chest still out. He's going to go one direction, switch, go to the other side. It's a one-legged squat, right? 20 pass-throughs. Bring out that broomstick again. Kelly's not riding it this time. Doing pass-throughs with the broomstick. If you remember with these pass-throughs, guys, try to think of inching your hands in closer and closer and closer with every single rep. We're moving on to then sit-ups. The sit-ups we're going to see in our workout today. The shoulders touch the ground at the top. The shoulders get past the hips. The shoulders touch the ground at the bottom. The shoulders get past the hips at the top. And then last but not least in our warm-up, guys, we've got 10 downward dog push-ups. In the downward dog portion, Noah's really going to drive his chest towards his toes. You can even pedal out the heels a little bit here, stretching the hamstrings. From then, he's going to come forward, do a traditional push-up, go right back in, and right back to that downward dog. Once again, 1 round of that for the warm-up today. All right, guys, so we're going to go through all the movements today. We're going to start out with our traditional workout equipment, and then we'll kind of demo other objects you can use that you have. So our first movement is a deadlift. We got 2 dumbbells that we can use. Dumbbells are going to set on the ground. Feet are going to be between the dumbbells. He's going to stand all the way up and then go back down, touching the dumbbells to the ground. Okay, if he turns to the side, things we're going to focus on, our stance is our hip width, right? As he goes down, the hips go back, the back stays flat the entire time. He stands up all the way for the rep to count. Let's see a few reps, Noah. Nice. The most important thing, guys, is keeping that back super flat, especially in the bottom here. We don't want to see anybody rounding their backs. So if we had to use some sort of other object for deadlifting, say maybe a laundry basket full of rocks, books, weight, anything to put in there to add some weight to it, same concepts. We just grip the object a little different. He's still going to stand up with it and back down. The movement is at the hips. The hips are going back as he goes down. The back is staying flat. Awesome. Okay. Okay. So, guys, we're talking about our pull-ups and how we can scale our pull-ups. We're looking at finding a table. Noah's underneath the table. Obviously, there's a lot of things that go into this. You know, maybe adding a friend on that other side to keep the table super steady. Book something that maybe won't roll off onto your face or onto your legs. But anyway, you want a sturdy object to be under. Okay. Once again, we're scaling our pull-ups with this. So Noah's going to be under it. What we found is being directly under the edge. So if your grip is here, having your shoulders and body directly under the table here will help not make it fall over. From there, you're going to do a ring row style pull-up. He's pulling his chest as close as he can to that table. We're trying to get all of our full range of movement there. The arms are extended at the bottom. This is going to vary on your table height. But this is how we can think about subbing scaling pull-ups today. Nice. Okay, let's talk about our cleans. When we move on to the cleans here. So traditional equipment, if you have a pair of dumbbells, this is what our clean looks like with the dumbbells from the ground. She's jumping and getting the bells to her shoulder. Right? So substituting objects from that, we can maybe use a backpack or a gym bag. From here, she's still doing the deadlift. She's spinning and still having the actions of those elbows to come around to catch the clean. All right, guys, push-ups. We're going to be doing lots of push-ups if anybody hasn't figured that out yet. Once again, we're starting on the ground in a tall plank position. Body is remaining flat. She's going to drive her elbows back towards her pockets. Her chest touches the ground. She finishes the rep fully extended at the top. All right, moving on to swings. So we're going to start with traditional gym equipment and use a kettlebell for our kettlebell swings. The bell starts on the ground. Back remains nice and flat. She's gonna hike it like a center in a football player. We can do American swings or we can do Russian swings, which is halfway up, and American swings would be full way up. She's utilizing her hips to produce power. Arms are relaxed. The rep starts at the bottom and then finishes at the top. To use another object for our kettlebell, okay? A paint can is pretty sweet. This kind of reminds me of Home Alone. Make sure the lid's on super solid. Otherwise, your hump day is going to be covered in paint.
Don't go overhead.
And don't go overhead with the kettle or with the paint can. It is not going to fare well overhead, so you're just going to go Russian swings. Same idea. That was close. Okay. Also, grab a dumbbell. You can do swings with a dumbbell as well. So if you just hold one end of the head, okay, swings can still happen with a dumbbell as well. Post your odd objects too. Like, post any weird object that you might use to substitute in these because we'd love to see it. And last but not least, guys, we have our sit-ups. Basic sit-up. She's going to go down to the ground. I like feet together, knees butterflied. We're looking for our shoulders to touch the ground in the back. And as she sits up, she can use her arms and shoulders in front of the hips at the top. Nice. So scaling this, guys, we can think about with this, you're working for a set amount of time, so you work as long as you can in that 20 seconds. Also, ways to scale this is judging, you know, using different weights, lower the weights, raise the weights of the objects, things of that nature. Use different objects where you can, and then our pull-ups we're scaling to our table pull-up. There's our Tabata-ish for today. We've got the 6 different movements. We're trying to remember to stay working for 20 seconds. You get that 10 seconds of rest after every bout of 20 seconds of work. So try to stay moving for that full 20 seconds. Post your score to your comments. This is a one big rep number. Make sure you log it into Wodify as well. And guys, let's see some videos or pictures of your odd objects and what you're choosing to use. Get to work.
Fucking nose and my teeth are missing.
And I don't want to go to the hospital.
Okay. All right, recording. Yeah.